We are at Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky. It is time for Big Blue Madness. The glitz and the glamour of the blue carpet takes us all to a big night in college basketball. Yeah, there's glamour there, and there are some hoops ready to be taken. And the boys are in the building, too. I thought I saw Big Z in the background there. We are ready to kick things off tonight from Lexington. Let's get Big Blue Madness started. From downtown Lexington, Kentucky, this is Rupp Arena. A sold-out crowd on hand for this one, and the seats still being filled in. Welcome, everybody, to Big Blue Madness. It is the unofficial start to college basketball. I'm Tom Hart. We are thrilled to be here tonight, as we are every year, to feature on the men's side the winningest program in college basketball history. Let's bring my buddy Jimmy Dykes. Jimmy, there's going to be some change. Folks in the building may need to buy a program because the top recruiting class in the country is here, and that roster has seen a lot of turnover.
Yeah, that roster change is what college basketball is all about right now across the country. Look at what Kentucky lost from last year, a team that made it to the second round of the NCAA tournament. The key guy returning to me is Antonio Reeves, a big-time shooter. I think he's going to have a monster year. How about this number one recruiting class? Edwards, Wagner, Bradshaw, all three of those guys right now projected in the first round of the NBA. The number one recruiting class for Calipari, once again, they are loaded in that position.
All right, that's only part of the night. We start with the women. Chrissy Thomas, Scotty, this is a women's team that's also replacing a lot of production from last year, but they have one superstar that's in the building tonight. That's Maddie Shear.
Absolutely. Last year wasn't the ideal because of what this program stands for. They've lost almost 65% of their point production. So what does Kyra Elzey do? She leans on her veterans. And when you got a player like Maddie Shear, that's the kind of player you want to build on. She is a Swiss Army knife. She is a stat stuffer, and she's an exciting player to watch.
That is enough from us, folks. Let's hear you. Let's get the party started. Welcome to Big Blue Madness.
From Moreno Valley, California, number 3, Jordy Griggs.
So you might think I flew.
Tell me what you say.
Cause I'm flyer, D.O. Dude. Hey, if you think I flew, then what are you a fool? I ain't got no exit.
A 6'4 freshman from Tyrone, Georgia. Number 44, Janae Walker. Body start to drop. Not a stop, watch, don't ever survive. A 5'6 sophomore from Florissant, Missouri. Number 2, Zaniya Tyler. A 5'6 sophomore from Virgie, Kentucky. Number 5, Cassidy Rowe.
She want that big bag, she don't want that little girl. I just get mad when you want that little girl. Drink a 6 down, tell bro to stop to get a kick. Worth them M's, 9, me and my little brother got a stick. Drunk as hell, woke up and forgot what I said. My Jay Brown, new Dior sneakers, kinda shy, but I lie. Think he slick, cause he tried to take his butt off. I lie. Boy, this up a little, it's only money. Gotta watch the sneaky, not the rock.
5'4 junior from Frankfort, Kentucky. 0 Brooklyn Miles.
Hey, nigga, right,
let's go.
Say she don't want me to leave, not selfish, feed the team. Ran up 100, just stop using bar, just call me a king. My white boy pull a little shit like I was a reed. It's 6'15, hey, better watch your back, no folk gon' bless you before you sneeze. I walk in, she catch up, eating up the joint, like I'm in the lead.
From Baltimore, Maryland, number 4, Inaya Russell.
This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want. Ha! 1600 block. I just wanna rock. I just wanna. I just wanna rock. Body out of y'all.
A 6'3 sophomore from Baltimore, Maryland. Number 13, Asia.
See the flow from Atlanta to LA. The only time I'm back and forth. Cheap, make you pee. Rich, get you both. Gator Bentley to valet and drive the boat. Be quiet. Let me pop off. Lead a club, sloppy homie. Boss, I rob me. Hurt from the south. He trying to see me knock his socks off. Told him, meet me at the top. Think they got lost. I'm on go like Grizz. She thought I would kiss her. She must ain't took no. I set it up. I love her.
A 6'3 senior from Blackwood, South Carolina, number 21, Naya Lavaretta.
This gorgeous. She's the most, but it's tent. It's enormous. I love staring at my. She gorgeous. She loves staring at my kid. It's gorgeous. My little pair of favorite words is you gorgeous. I keep talking to my wrist like you gorgeous.
A 5'10 graduate student from Stanford, Kentucky. Number 34. Emma.
Oh. Southern groans, got these swinging balls.
Your Wildcats are assisted by Associate Head Coach Nia Butts, Assistant Coaches Jen Hoover and Crystal Kelly. From 2007 to 2020, Matthew Mitchell. And the current head coach of your Kentucky women's basketball team, Kyra Elzy. One more time for your Kentucky women's basketball program.
Well, the torch has been passed. Kyra Elzy, the head coach of the Kentucky women's basketball program, will see her team on the floor when we return to Rupp Arena. Welcome back to Rupp Arena. Kentucky Big Blue Madness rolls on. Kyra Elzy's women's team on the floor, going through the layup lines and getting loose and ready to go here tonight. We got some surprises in store for you, as always, with Big Blue Madness. But, Jimmy, let's start with this. How about passing the torch to all the former coaches in the house tonight? How cool was that?
Yeah, great night for Kentucky women's basketball program. I mean, they've had a lot of success here, some All-Americans. You can't think about Kentucky's women's program without thinking about Valerie Steele, the all-time leading scorer and rebounder, both men's and women.
Speaking of a great score, Maddie Shears standing by with Christy Thomas-Cuddy. All right, right, we're having technical difficulties right now, but I imagine, Jimmy, she was saying, hey, listen, how important are you to this program? Because when she was on the floor last year versus missing some games, man, what a huge difference and what a huge benefit for Kyrie Elzey with everything they've lost to have someone so reliable and at times dominant on the floor.
Tom, you're exactly right. This is a program that they struggled last year, only two wins in conference play. They found their way, though, late in the year, picked up some wins in that SEC tournament, the first 14 seed to ever make it to the quarterfinals, and Maddie Shear was the leader of that charge. She's the tone setter. She's a good talent that has great effort. She cares about the right things. I was really impressed with her leadership, her voice yesterday morning in practice for a couple of hours. A Kentucky kid that comes back home from Oregon, and I know that Kyra Elzey is looking for huge leadership and big points in production from Maddie Shear this year.
Yeah, originally from Florence, y'all, so it's nice to have her back in the Commonwealth for another season, one of four former Miss Kentucky basketballs on this Kentucky roster for the season. All right, let's try it again. Let's get over to Christy and Maddie.
Well, sorry about that, Tom. That was my turnover. Assist fashion. Maddie Shears with me here now. Maddie, by Kentucky standard, last year was disappointing. What have you specifically done and put up on your shoulders to make sure that this team is ready to win this season?
Just reminded the team that we're not going to be there again. It's going in with a different mindset. We're going to learn from last year and come in even better. And we all have a mindset that we're not going to be where we were last year.
All right, Maddie, everybody wants to know, who's the player in your mind that we need to be paying special attention to here tonight?
Everybody. I'm really excited about this whole team. I don't think BBN has gotten to see a lot of these players. So everybody, I'm really excited.
Thanks, Maddie.
But Maddie all smiles and for good reason. Emma King on the floor, speaking of Kentucky kids in the blue and white, getting ready to go tonight. And we'll see some shooting drills. We'll see some scrimmaging on the midside. We'll have a dunk contest and a three-point contest. And Jimmy, this team, you mentioned their success in the SEC tournament. Back-to-back seasons where even though maybe some disappointment during the regular season, 2 years ago with Ryan Howard and the success that she's had in the WNBA, and then to go into Greenville and put together wins. I think that says something about the team mentality that at the end of the year, you're still together enough to find some victory.
No, absolutely, because you can lose your team and lose your hope. And Kyra's kids never did that last year. And, you know, you have to have a strong leader when things are going south on you a little bit. And Maddie Shear certainly is that. You mentioned Emma. I like this team, though. They don't have a lot of depth. And this is a coach that likes to play pressure basketball on both ends. So I expect Kentucky to bounce back this year. The problem is it's such an unforgiving league. You're going to look at five or six teams out of the SEC on the women's side to be ranked in that preseason top 25, and it all starts up top with LSU and Kim Mulkey.
All right, well, we're getting some shooting competition in, and got 6 minutes on the clock. We're going to use both sides of the court here for this one. By the way, a court that will be home to the women's team here at Rupp Arena this season. You were a couple of practices, but Memorial Coliseum undergoing renovations, so you get a chance to play here at Rupp. And we are off and running. Nine returners, three newcomers to this roster, and the newcomers include two freshmen, Jordy Griggs, Janae Walker, and a Tennessee native, Tennessee transfer, by the way, Kentucky native Brooklyn Miles will be running the point at times throughout the course of the season. I think it's what a huge opportunity for them to call Rupp Arena their home floor, Jimmy, each and every game, as opposed to coming over occasionally or for a big game for a moment, because as a shooter, especially getting used to these sight lines relative to what you have at Memorial, it takes some getting used to.
It does, but I tell you what, for as big as Rupp Arena is, I think it's always been a very friendly shooting background. And I thought these young ladies shot the ball really well yesterday morning. They didn't always shoot it straight last year. But the problem last year, and Christy knows as well as I do, that they just didn't have the right chemistry. It never came together for them. I don't know if they fought each other a little bit, maybe fought coaching some. I think all that is out of their system. From what I've seen, Christy, you've talked to the coaches as well, but I think there's a much more together, unselfish group so far.
Well, once again, Christy broke another microphone.
Christy.
I mean, she is
an expensive night for her.
That's right. This is unbelievable. Well, getting the scouting report from Christy, by the way, helped me out learning a lot about this team. And one of those that will be the key will be Asia Petty in terms of her having a huge offseason, dedicating and rededicating herself to the game and learning. Jimmy, let's be honest, and Christy, it takes work to be good at this game, and it seems like Asia Petty figured that out.
Okay.
Maybe I'm just throwing bad passes.
Hang in there, Christy. He's not a great point guard. I'm just telling you from experience.
Very well be it. All right.
Asia Petty.
Oh, you've never sounded better.
Hello, everybody.
Push the record button.
Quiet. Asia Petty dedicated herself this offseason, did every weight room workout, every skill development workout. She PR'd at every aspect of the weight room. That shows dedication, and you've got to have your veteran players buying in like that if you're going to have a bump in the win-loss record like Kentucky's expecting to do.
Well, what a lesson that is for everybody else, whether it be your roommate or your teammates or in the locker room that see not only you working hard, but your work and hard work paying off.
Absolutely. And that's what's unfortunate in this day and age of the transfer portal and everything else, is players want it immediately. But I'll tell you, as a former coach, you got to pay the dues. The game knows. Asia Petty's always had the skill. I am really eager to see how that pays off for her on the floor this season.
A great crowd on hand here for Big Blue Madness early on, and it's only going to continue to build. I thought not only bringing out the coaches was really cool, but all of these coaches have been able to spend some time with this program since they've been in town. And it was funny, they all kind of had the same message, right? I was talking with one of the players today, and she said, you know, we heard it from each and every coach, and just that reinforcement that what we need to be doing to do things well and to do things right, decades of experience coming at us.
Well, every coach that we saw has had success. Kara Elzey has had success, but it's easier to hear it from someone on the outside, unfortunately, than it is your own coach, because every day this coaching staff is saying the same thing, and it's the right thing. It's a matter now for these players to apply it every day, and that's the thing. Can they be consistent every day?
All right, so it seems we got three-point contest getting going, and Maddie Shear is going to start things off. 5'11 senior. Couldn't flush the money ball and off to the next rack.
We'll just blame that turnover on me, too. I kept her out from warming up.
You
to
did.
Get ready for this. So that's all on me, Maddie. I mean, Maddie is their best three-point returning shooter last year. And the key with Maddie is just letting the game come to her, because she is so good in so many different ways. She pressed early in the season last year. And Kyra Elzey told her, I don't want you to score. And from that point on, she was a terror on the offensive end for this ball club.
Oh, by the way, also chipped in with more than four assists a game.
Swiss Army knife.
Yeah.
She's a stat sheet stuffer. And led the team in blocks.
Oh, my God.
As a guard.
Reset her career high in scoring four times, including all against top 25 teams, 18 against Louisville, 22 against LSU, 25 against USC, 27 against the Lady Vols, and that's a great round of 18 for Maddie Shear. So 18 right off the bat. We got four contestants tonight. Two of them will move on to the final round. And next up is Emma King. Is it? Nope. We're going to Cassidy. Cassie Rowe from the 606 at a Shelby Valley High School.
You talk to anyone around this program, and Cassie Rowe bleeds blue. She is Kentucky basketball through and through. I was told today by one of the players that anytime they have to pick teams, regardless of what the competition is, players get upset if Cassidy's not on their team, because they know whichever team Rowe is on is going to wind up winning.
Oh, money ball was halfway down.
You know, one thing about the three-point contest is you can practice it, but when the lights come on, it's about pace and being consistent in that pace. And you'll see it usually. The women tend to get a little fatigued by the time they get to this third or fourth rack, because they went so fast early. Either that or they're on fire and they just get in that groove.
Yeah, it looks like Cassidy has found a rhythm, and she throws in the money ball. One rack left. Remember, the top two move on to the final round. And after Maddie put up an 18, Cassidy is going to follow up with a pretty good number herself. Yes, sir.
With a score of 15.
An 18 and a 15. We got pretty high bars set for the final two contestants. Right, here's Emma King out of Stamford, Kentucky, Lincoln County High School. She is no stranger to this event. She came out with the cowboy hat and the intros and the country music. And
that's what I call owning your style.
That's right.
You know, Kyra Elsie said, Emma King deciding to save this 50 was really important. They need her veteran leadership. She is that player who gives her all, whether it's practice or games. And what I think this coaching staff is really looking for in this last year from Emma is, can all the hard work and practice start to pay dividends come game time?
Well, she's getting hot. Emma King on a jelly roll here late in this one on second to last rec.
She's at 15.
There it is. So Emma had to knock one of these down, running out of time. So Emma with a 17, Maddie had an 18.
And last but not least, we have Sanaya Tyler. Sanaya, you ready?
And now Sanaya Tyler.
Three, two,
St. Louis native out of Florissant, Missouri, Incarnate Word. Fantastic high school program. She came out with big energy in the intros.
Well, and speaking with Nia Butts, Associate Coach Nia Butts today, she said that Tyler's now playing the way we expected her to. Freshman year is hard for anyone,
yeah,
especially a point guard in that transition. And every coach that I talked to this week raved about Tyler's production this entire preseason and what she's been bringing to the court.
There's the first for Sanaya, and back to back. That'll get the confidence up a little bit. Three out of five makes. So our final is set. We'll see who gets to go first between Maddie Shear and Emma King.
Well, in true competitive fashion, when Emma King got done shooting, Maddie Shear was the first person to greet her and say, no, you're not beating my score.
Emma, you're up first.
All right, who's up first?
Emma, you ready?
Emma's going to get it started. So an advantage, Chrissy, in many ways, for Maddie to go second here, knowing what the number is going to be, especially after Emma had a couple of early misses.
I think it's a shooter's mentality. I think Emma's right now thinking, I'm going to set the standard that Maddie has to try to beat.
Let's go, Emma.
Meanwhile, I had a great interview with Eddie that no one heard but me.
Well,
she's tremendous.
You wanted it all for yourself.
Did you use the mic I used?
No, I switched. they gave me yours. I said, no, thank you.
You know, you should put that on your blog, Jimmy. We'll all go check it out.
Well, I like how she shoots that basketball, right? Same way every time.
Like a Kentucky true blood shooter.
Exactly. You grew up in this state, you know a couple of things. One of them is how to shoot a basketball.
A good finish for Emma King, but couldn't live up to her first round number. Now, Maddie Shear knows what she's got to do. Maddie had an 18. In her opening round.
You ready? Three, two, one.
Money ball's worth two. A miss on the first rack with the bonus.
That's how she shot it yesterday morning for about 2 hours.
She shot her whole career, Kenny.
What I like about her misses, they're not short. And, boy, good shooters, the best shooters, they don't miss short. They might miss long. They don't leave it short. And look at Maddie. That's a beautiful stroke.
She is a joy to watch. Like, I remember a couple of games, even when she was at Oregon, though, you get caught just watching her effort because she is disruptive on both ends of the floor. She missed two games last year, Jimmy. Offensively, Kentucky struggled to score by 20 points less in both those games. Mm. But what really got to me was defensively. They gave up 16 more on average per game without her. Wow. Influences every aspect of the game.
Hard to take her off the floor, right, as a coach?
Absolutely.
Yeah, Maddie cashes in. It will take the three-point contest, hit the gritty, and get ready for whatever's next. Jimmy, she's still your dance move.
We worked on it yesterday morning.
All right, now we'll have a scrimmage with the women's team. Chrissy, what should we be looking for when they take the floor here, 5v5?
I think it's going to be pace. This is a team under Kyra Elzey that wants to get up and down. They want to turn you over. I'm not expecting a lot of the run and jump and defense here in this scrimmage. However, what I'm really looking for is both the new guards. How do they really work with the veterans? But it's also the post play. They need some young posts to step up for this team to be successful this year.
All right, we'll send Chrissy over to talk with Kyra Elzey throughout the course of this scrimmage. And we'll see exactly how they run things, Jimmy. Two wins in conference play last year, but multiple wins in the postseason and the SEC tournament once again. And really cool in the offseason, this team had a chance to go visit Ryan Howard, who was such a power for this program. And when you get that and you get an opportunity to do things together, those are some of the team building exercises that pay off late in the year.
You know, I visited with Ryan Howard at Kentucky's men's practice, I believe, on Pro Day. She was here. She'd been watching this Kentucky women's team play, and she said, I'm really encouraged because we're back to playing with pace. We're back to pushing the ball. This is a pressure-oriented system. Matthew Mitchell had it as well when he's a head coach, passing on down to Kyra Elzey. And the key in that pace and push with pressure is, can you take care of the basketball? A little careless with it in practice, I thought, yesterday. Something they'll have to clean up. Look at this. You got the two-point guard jumping center. I love this. How often do you see that?
Never. Let's have some fun here. Let's see if Christy's with Kyra and ready to go.
I'm here with head coach Kyra Elzey. Kyra, your team is known for their defense. Almost 20 points a game last year off of the defense. Are we expecting to see more of the same with so many newcomers?
Absolutely. That's what our program was built on. Now she banked the three in. She wanted to wait till after the three-point contest. But, you know, we're going to take pride in playing defense. We got to have scoring opportunities off of our defense. We forced 20.7 a year ago, and we want to stay on the same train.
Well, since Tyler just knocked down that three, everyone I've spoken to this week has been raving about her preseason. Can you talk more about her and what you're expecting from her this season? From Sanaya Tyler.
Yeah, you know, she really grew up at the end of last year, and we needed her to. She's a two-way scorer or two-way player. She can score and she can play defense, and we need her. We need her this year.
Well, we're missing two of your veteran post players out here in Asia Petty and Leveretter. What can you tell all of Big Blue Nation about your young posts who are on the floor here tonight?
You know, I'm so excited about Jordy and Janae. You know, they bring a confidence to the game that we need. They work hard. But also, I want to give a big shout out to Asia Petty. She's not playing here tonight, but she had an unbelievable summer. And we're looking for big things from her.
I think every coach would love to know the magic words that you said to Asia at the end of last season to really light that fire, because she is a new player right now for you.
She's a new person, but you know, she changed her mindset. She's really worked hard, changed her mentality. We'll keep it a secret what we said, but we've had a bonding moment at that time, but you know, she stepped up to the challenge.
And what about the addition of Brooklyn Miles? Gives you another guard with a little bit of experience. What is she going to help in terms of, especially Maddie Shear on the floor?
You know, what Brooklyn brings is that edge, that dog mentality. When, you know, when you're talking about getting after it 94 feet, her ability to push the tempo, but she's also a vocal leader.
Well, I feel like I've just been waiting and building up. Let's talk about Maddie Shear. I mean, I love watching her. Can you talk about how much fun it is to coach a player like Maddie Shear?
I mean, I love coaching her. She's a coach's dream. She is competitive. She's competitive. She wants to win at all costs. She's a pro. Look forward to seeing what she does this year.
So rumor has a year ago, Maddie had that winner. She didn't understand maybe why at all times everyone didn't. It seems like even watching practice, that has been bestowed on your team. Is that just growing up, or is Maddie taking more of an ownership in that leadership position?
Well, she's taking a leadership role, and we need her too. And she brings the competitive drive that we needed. Last year, I thought she was trying to still find her voice. But this year, she has it, and she's bringing her teammates along.
All right, I'm going to get coach speak now. In terms of the improvement areas, what have been those focuses for this team in order to take the next step?
You know, a year ago, I didn't think we could get over the hump. There was just, we took too many possessions off. And this year, we're just trying to value every possession. You don't know if it's going to be the 50-50 play. You don't know if it's going to be the offensive rebound, the defensive stop. But we were in a lot of close games a year ago, and we just need to finish.
You've got a lot of Kentucky players now on this roster. Can you talk about what it's like to build a roster around your homegrown kids?
You know, they have a different love for this program. They love this state. BBN has watched them grow up, and so they understand the responsibility and the reward it takes.
And one of those born and raised is Emma King. I know that you guys love Emma King. Bleeds blue on so many levels. What are you expecting from Emma, or what do you need from Emma this season?
Well, what we need from Emma is just her leadership. She fits everything that we're talking about. She is the epitome of everyone that I want to be a Kentucky Wildcat. She's going to work hard. She's coachable. She's going to do all the little things to make our team better.
Well, we just saw a three go down. This team has relied on the long ball a lot during your tenure. Do we feel like that's an area of improvement with this squad this year?
Absolutely. You know, we got to be able to hit the outside shot. We want to push in transition. We're undersized but extremely versatile. So this is going to be a fun team. They've been a lot of fun to coach, and I like that they've embraced the grind, the mentality. Okay, that's a freshman. I'm sorry. The coach has come out to me. Jordy! Jordy, pass that ball. See, now that's the really coaching. I'm sorry. I was supposed to just be watching.
Well, no. For everybody at home, a coach never turns it off when she's in front of her team.
So, you know, but this team really embraced the grind this summer, and I look forward to what we can do.
Your sophomores didn't play a lot a year ago. We're seeing a lot of scoring from them already. What's been the biggest jump for them in terms of really adjusting now in this sophomore season?
Well, you know, I think a year ago they lost their confidence early, and we really talked about going back to work and starring in your role and bringing what you can. Don't compare yourself to others. Bring what you bring and do it well. And they've really embraced that. But sometimes you don't have any experience until you have some. So they were baptized by fire a year ago, and that's going to help us in the long run.
Kyra, I mean, just put it into words for people who are not here tonight. What this means for your program, all these fans here in the preseason to support you and your program?
Well, this atmosphere, Big Blue Nation fans are the best in the country. I love that they come support. This will be our home court this year, so it is a takeover, Rupp takeover. We've already started, so takeover time.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, Chrissy, great job. Blue with the blowout over the white, 20-6. Must have been the Hampton brothers out there calling this game. I didn't hear a single whistle.
Are you all ready for basketball season?
Yeah, that's I like what
are
I saw, though.
Getting
up and down the floor, and coach knows what she wants to see.
Well, it's time. Our home gym this year will be Rupp Arena. We hope to see you all here. The takeover starts right now. If y'all are going to join us in Rupp Arena this year, let me hear you say, go Big Blue! Go Big Blue! This is the team you want to watch. Thank you all for coming out. Thank you all for being the best fans in the country. We'll see you all in Rupp Arena.
And that's the way to command the moment. Kyra Elzey, imploring folks to come out and see them at Rupp Arena as they make the move downtown. When we return, we will see the multi-time national champions. The Kentucky cheerleading squad will be on the floor. Big Blue Madness is well underway. We've already had the introduction of the women's team. High energy on the stage. And the torch being passed with all the former coaches in the building tonight, the 50th anniversary season of Kentucky women's basketball. Maddie Cheer hit the gritty after winning the three-point contest. And the Blue had a blowout win in the scrimmage against the White. And now, Jimmy Dykes, we get to see a Big Blue Madness Kentucky cheer squad. 24-time national champions will take the floor under the direction of Ryan Martin O'Connor. You won't find anyone better ever.
Now, they're the best in the country, and they have been for years. You mentioned the 24 national titles. Tom, they were 0.3 points away from winning their 25th national title last year. That's how close they were, the national runners-up. You're going to see 44 athletes on the mat tonight when they go to compete for nationals in Orlando. Coach O'Connor will cut that down to 20. She has nine seniors this year. She says this is a team that's player-led, which we all like that, you know, as former coaches. And they practice four times a week. They lift twice a week on top of cheering at two or three different events. And it's a full-time job. It required study hall hours and no off-season for this Kentucky cheer program. They set the bar in collegiate cheer.
And athletically, there are going to be some things that you see on the mat tonight as you're watching. That is going to make your jaw drop. It's one of my favorite parts of Big Blue Madness year in and year out. So enough of us. Let's check out the powerhouse program, Kentucky Cheer. Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with. Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of it, at least you got to win.
Tom, I've always said, if you can coach, you can coach. And I've actually been to Kentucky's cheer practice a couple of times over the years. And Ryan Martin O'Connor, the head coach of Kentucky, she runs as good of a practice, Christy, as you'll see in terms of accountability, holding kids to a high level, a high standard, pushing them in the right way. You win 24 national titles as a program, there's a certain bar that's set. And I don't care what sport it is, it all starts with that head coach. And she has taken over a program and making a charge for another national championship. I just love watching good coaches work, you know?
Yeah, and great athletes too. By the way, your preparation knows absolutely no limits. So each and every year I do Big Blue Madness with you, you're the one that comes with the scouting report on the entire cheer squad. Well, never cease to amaze me.
When you're married to a head high school cheer coach, you talk cheerleading a lot at home.
Jimmy, I just love that you talk, first and foremost, they're athletes.
Yes.
And as an old lady who can barely do a forward roll, much less straight, it's remarkable to watch them and to see not only the athletic ability, but that stamina. They're not standing still very long, and just to continue to do, because it's in basketball, you're vertical or you're up in the air very shortly. They're in the air a long time, such a risk of injury, and they perform flawlessly.
And yeah. The precision of these drills, and to your point about the stamina, it's like a great fireworks show. The grand finale will be the toughest, and so you have to be at your best at the end of the game, just like the squad.
Yeah, they start off every fall practice with a timed mile. There's a certain mark that they have to hit for both the men and the women, where you're seeing some outstanding tumbling, some pulls, some great passes being done right now. Wow.
So, Jimmy, what was that twisty thing called?
A twisty thing? I think that was a full into another full and a half.
Oh, look at that.
I see you. You want to stay clean, not any drops. So many times. Just think about it. They lost the national championship last year by 0.3 points. There's the hand in hands.
I never know what I'm more impressed with when they toss the young ladies in the air. The fearlessness of the young ladies to go sky high, or the gentlemen who push them up so high and then catch them.
How about the trust factor of 20 feet in the air in Rupp Arena, knowing that someone's going to catch you? That's trusting your teammate, right?
There's no trust fall here.
No. That's a big-time routine right now. They've been going for a good 3 minutes, to your point about conditioning, how important it is.
And mental focus, because you take that split second off,
yeah,
and it's a drop.
Performance of 24-time national champions. Their moment in the spotlight here at Big Blue Madness. 0.3 of a point was the difference.
That's how close it 25. Is to that national championship. And Kentucky's charging hard to try to get another one later on this winter.
All right, so when we return, John Calipari's team with the number one recruiting class in the country will be on the floor as Big Blue Madness rolls on from Rupp. Full slate of college football tomorrow on the SEC Network. I'm most looking forward to Missouri here at Rupp, in Lexington to take on Kentucky. You two, however, focus on Arkansas, the Jimmy Dykes version, and Alabama. Chrissy, you got some Alabama.
Well, on paper, everyone's saying Alabama should win, but I think it's a dangerous game. One, we know Arkansas is going to play for Sam Pittman.
Yep.
Two, is Alabama looking ahead to Tennessee next week?
Here's what concerns me if I'm Alabama. Arkansas has lost four in a row, I believe, but they've been in every game. They're just a couple of plays away from having two or three wins right now. That's an Arkansas team that's so dangerous with K.J. Jefferson. Just as low to bring down, but I trust Alabama's defense, Chris, if I'm you at the end of the day.
Absolutely, but it's the inconsistency of Alabama football that has Alabama fans.
You're going to watch that game, aren't you?
I am, but hey, Jimmy, as we all know, it's SEC football, so bring it or go home.
Incredible performance by the Kentucky dance team that we got to see here in-house. They leave the floor, and we move a step closer to getting introduced to John Calipari's squad for this coming season. The winningest program in college basketball once again. They have reclaimed that title. Time to come back to Big Blue Madness, Jimmy. It's not just about the current players, but the past players are part of La Familia and part of this program, even obviously pre-Cal in the great history of this program.
Well, it's a program that they expect to win a national championship every year, and there's nothing wrong with that expectation. Not so sure how real it is, but you know, they'll be in the conversation, I believe, when we get to late February and March. It's such a young team. They lost so much. It's a rebuild. Here's the problem for Kentucky. The SEC this year is absolutely loaded, Tom. It is absolutely loaded. And they had eight teams in the NCAA tournament last year. I'm not so sure they can't get to 9 or 10 this year. That's how deep this league is.
And it's not the typical names. It's not just the typical names, right? Texas A&M, Missouri,
absolutely,
that are sitting there ready to make their impact. They're on their feet. Well, some of them here at Rupp Arena. We get a chance to get an up-close personal look at this year's roster.
75 through 78. One more time, a big hand for your University of Kentucky men's basketball alumni.
This was probably four of the greatest years of my life.
It's totally different from anything else, any other program.
Kentucky's for a guy who wants to make a dream a reality.
Every time that I look in the mirror, all these lines on my face getting clearer. The past is gone.
There's no word that will describe the feeling of winning the national championship. It was a dream come true.
In the history of college basketball. Let's meet your 2023 Kentucky men's basketball team. A 6'2 sophomore from Cincinnati, Ohio, number 13, Grant Derbyshire. Texas, number 22, Walker Horn. A 5'8" senior from Camden, New Jersey, number 25, Kareem Watkins.
Watch how many people try U-turns when it rained over. I take my losses to the chin, I ain't complain, I let the pain mold. I just won 100 M's, LeBro won 100 trophies. He ain't want to throw the ball to him, and he was wide open.
A 6'6" grad student from Mount Sterling, Kentucky, number 14, Brennan Canada. A 6'9" freshman from Decatur, Alabama, number 23, Jordan Burks. A 6'2" freshman from Hickory, North Carolina, number 0, Rob Dillingham.
Cash on me, yeah, you know she capping on me. Dreadlock that cap on me. Back then they napped on me. Now
a 6'8" freshman from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 1, Justin Edwards.
I just wanna rock. Body out of ya. You know she got that body out of ya. Where they going? No time, set up. You gon' kill my dog. Stand on my money, don't know my time.
A 6'5" freshman from Linton, Indiana, number 20, Joey Hart. A 7'2" freshman from Modice, Croatia, number 44, Zadomir Ivicic. A 6'3" freshman from London, Kentucky, number 15, Reed Shepherd.
I'm better than my father was, and where he came from too. Open the gate, I'm here to ride. Tell her how I go.
A 6'3" freshman from Camden, New Jersey, number 21, DJ Wagner.
Under the sun, I come from under the Tommy, busting a demon. You come from under your demon, just in your arm.
A 6'11" sophomore from Awori, Imo State, Nigeria, number 33, Ugata Onyenso. A 6'6" sophomore from Leedsdale, Pennsylvania, number 3, Adu Thierro. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, number 4, Trey Mitchell.
West Cowboy, Pittsburgh. Again came from a city where the freaking they some. Midwest Cowboy, Pittsburgh. Again came from a city where the freaking they some.
And a 6'5", fifth year from Chicago, Illinois, number 12, Antonio Reed.
I got the whole world rocking with me. This stuck it. Put up in the left. Put up in the big song. I just be leaving the earth.
No one on the corner has swagger like us.
Nation, welcome home, 2010 SEC Champion, 2010 SEC Tournament Champion, 2010 Elite Eight, fifth overall pick in the NBA Draft, four-time NBA All-Star, Olympic gold medalist, DeMarcus Boogie Cousins!
Big Blue, what's happening? What's happening? Super excited to be back tonight. This is my first time in about, I'ma say, 14 years since I've been at Big Blue. So I'm super excited to be here. I got the pleasure of introducing, you know, Hall of Fame coach, the GOAT. Y'all better put some respect on his name, Coach Calipari. What's up, coach?
Mac, I'm gonna. A millionaire, I'm a young money millionaire.
The greatest fans anywhere. You make a difference for us everywhere we go. You fill this arena, and we thank you. When you coach, there's some good stuff said and there's some bad stuff said. But when guys come home, there's nothing better for a coach. I love this guy, Boogie, as we know him. He has been, never left us, never left me. We haven't left you either. But let's have some fun tonight. Let's watch these guys play and enjoy it, and let's get on with this. Thank you.
One more time for your 2023-2024 University of Kentucky Wildcat men's basketball team and alumni.
How cool is that? Boogie Cousins, fifth overall pick in the 2010 draft, back in the house tonight. Cal's team will be on the floor right after this. A really cool moment here at Rupp Arena. Kentucky basketball alums like Anthony Davis, John Wall, addressing the crowd via video. And maybe the loudest ovation for former player of the year, Oscar Tshiebwe. Tom Hart, Christy Thomas-Cuddy, Jimmy Dykes in the building tonight. Christy, this is your first experience of Big Blue Madness. How about the energy in this building?
Tom, I'm just gonna say, it's a letdown after this. I mean, this isn't even a November game, and it is electric. I have goosebumps from the moment I stepped in here, and it is not disappointed.
All right, let's get across the floor. Jimmy's got one of the stars. Jimmy Dykes, the floor is yours.
Tom, I'm here with Aaron Bradshaw, one of the McDonald's All-Americans in this freshman class. Aaron, a year ago at Big Blue Madness, you committed to be a Kentucky Wildcat. Why was that? What was so special about this night?
Yeah, it was just electric, the fans, everybody. I can't explain that feeling because it was just so surreal. Like, every single body coming up to me, clapping me up, and like just giving me the love that I wanted, and it was just like, I ain't gonna lie, I don't like that.
Signed right now.
Yeah, it was just a crazy.
So you've been injured a little bit.
Yes, sir.
But when you're back healthy, what kind of player is Aaron Bradshaw? Describe your game.
I just want to win. I'm gonna do everything I gotta win. Rebound, block shots, shoot shots, box out, whatever I gotta do to win the game, I'm gonna do it.
What have you seen from your teammates so far watching them in practice? What's the strength of this ball club early?
We all play together. Everybody, like, we bond real, real good together. We all mesh together. Everybody play for each other, and we all, like, do stuff for each other.
There's a reason why John Calipari brings recruits into Big Blue Madness. It paid off last year with Aaron Bradshaw. Aaron, look forward to watching you play, buddy.
Appreciate that, man.
Man, this is going to be a lot of fun. Bradshaw out maybe another 5 to 6 weeks. The foot injury that he suffered during the McDonald's All-America game over the course of the summer. Regular season starts November 6th. I got Kansas November 14th. They're going to ask a lot of some of these other guys to try to step in and find some support. And when you're able to add height late, that will certainly help John Calipari's squad out. The guy everybody wants to see tonight has a basketball in his hand right now. Zanimir Ivicic is on the floor, just went through the layup line. And Chrissy, when you're able to bring in a 7'2" freshman who just arrived after 13 hours of travel from Croatia, might be a little much to expect a ton of them right off the bat, but he's a guy that they want some performance from.
An athlete is an athlete, and when you look at this body, I see wingspan. I'm imagining what he can do on defense, but we know he is a pure shooter. Imagine just a regular 6-foot guard trying to close out on this young man. It's gonna be money for Kentucky. I am really looking forward to see his growth in the next couple of years.
He was in the building yesterday when we were at practice. The first thing he did, they sat him down, they gave him a steak. Hey, Big Z, let's get you bigger, huh? But Cal has always had great rim protection with his elite teams. You saw Anthony Davis up on the video board a moment ago. There's no question, Jimmy, what he has in the backcourt, though. I mean, the number one recruited class, and the strength of that will have the ball in its hands more often than not.
The guard play this year is ridiculously good for John Calipari. It's just Antonio Reeves, that upperclassman, but man, all those freshman guards, even Justin Edwards at 6'8", I consider a perimeter player. But John Calipari's teams, Tom, to your point, they've got to get back to that high-level defense that he had those first 10 years rolling here. To your point, the last 2 years, they have averaged less than 5 blocks per game.
Wow.
This is a club that, at their best, they're in that 6 or 7 blocks per game. That rim protection is so important. Cal has always said if you don't have a true post player, your team's a fraud, and it really shows up on both ends of the floor. They have 21 feet of post play that's not quite ready to go yet because of injuries, and the big Croatian kid just got in. But when they have the complete roster, they have everything you look for, I think, for a team that can make a really deep run.
Well, I can't wait to see this backcourt on the floor. It includes DJ Wagner, of course, and this is a New Jersey flavor to this team. You mentioned, by the way, in terms of returning players, Antonio Reeves, who really grew into his role and now will have an opportunity, especially early in the season, with the ball in his hand to grow a little bit more.
You know, he was Kentucky's best scorer the last 7 or 8 games last year and had an outstanding summer shooting the basketball. I think he's capable of shooting 45-46% from three. That's how good his stroke is. He's also gotten a little stronger talking to NBA scouts. They are impressed with his ability to drive through contact right now and finish. Something that he struggled with, I think, his time at Illinois State and even last year at Kentucky, but a much more physical, mature, confident version of Antonio Reeves. Talk about that guard play from Cal. Think about it. He has produced 3 NBA All-Stars at the guard spot. Devin Booker, John Wall, Derrick Rose, and just the numbers of names that come up. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, Bledsoe, Tyler Hero, Ty Washington, Tyler Ulis. Where does it end? And it continues this year with guys like DJ Wagner.
So what I hear you saying, Jimmy, is that Cal knows what to do when he's got talent. And we know what this freshman class can do. And I think that takes pressure off Reeves. I think you got other playmakers on the floor where he can then spot up. But all we keep hearing is how selfless this team is and how well they're playing together. And I want to talk about Trey Mitchell. I think as much as we're going to hype up these freshmen, Trey Mitchell is vital for this team to make that deep run in the tournament play.
Yeah, the transfer from West Virginia is the ultimate connector. And watching him in practice and at Pro Day, you know, he can make a shot from the perimeter and space the defense. He's a really good playmaker, a phenomenal passer for a kid his size. And I think what's impressive to me about Trey Mitchell, Tom, is he came in from day one and his voice mattered.
Yeah.
And he was very confident with his voice. And, you know, for a young team, they're going to follow somebody's voice. Boy, Trey Mitchell, number 4, is a really good late pickup for this Kentucky program by Cal.
All right, we've got a couple of things in store for you tonight. 3-point contest is next. We'll have a dunk contest a little bit later. Then this team will see the floor probably 4-on-4 instead of 5v5. Men's 3-point contest coming up next from Rupp. All right, warm-ups are complete. We're getting ready for the 3-point contest here in a moment. We'll have 5 contestants and
and two will move on to the final round. Antonio Reeves with 80 threes for this team last year. Best returning shooter.
Tom, shooting is the swing skill for most guys. When you project them, how high can they go as a basketball player and also as a team overall? And
Calipari's
guys are so good at the dribble drive, but you have to have guys that can shoot it and space the floor. I think they have it this year. I mean, Mitchell can shoot the basketball really well. Wagner's got a good stroke. Reed Shepard, 15 from right here in Kentucky, shoots the ball as well as any freshman I've seen in a long time. The consistency of his rotation is just like you draw it up.
And you were here for Pro Day, so you got to see Shepard shot really well. Of course, they played in Toronto at the Global Jam over the course of the summer. And then, by the way, not just the Pro Day here at Rupp, but a practice the day after Pro Day with all the NBA scouts in attendance and watching that very thing.
Well, I think it's such a special thing about Kentucky, and John Calipari started that Pro Day back in 2014. He was the first one with the vision to do it, and he pulled it off. And now, this is a Kentucky program. Cal's been so good about it. If you're the head coach of Kentucky and all you do is watch film in your office, you are cheating the position. He's always had a vision and very creative in what he does with his program. The Pro Day is one example. I love the guard play for Kentucky right now as much as I've loved over the last several years. It's not just one guy, four or five guys, legit from the perimeter.
All right, we've got five contestants. We'll start with Reed Shepard. The other contestants will be Joey Hart, DJ Wagner, Antonio Reeves, and Trey Mitchell. So Reed Shepard, 6'3", 180, sees the floor really well. Another Mr. Kentucky basketball. They had the original back in 1954. They had three straight with the Unforgettables. We'll actually start with Rex, and then two more of them, including John Pelfrey. Of course, he's got the lineage here with both mom and dad.
Are we making picks? Who's going to win? Christy, who you got?
I'm going with Antonio Reeves.
That's a good call, Tom.
I'd like to go with I want Reed still, even though he's off to a slow start. I'm not going to let it.
Oh, okay. I'm going to curveball. I'm going with Joey Hart, the freshman from Indiana.
My favorite jersey on the floor.
Reed Shepard grew up around Kentucky basketball, right, with his dad and his mom both. His mom, Stacy, was a terrific player for the women's program. How about this? The best lane agility speed on this Kentucky program, Reed Shepard. Much better athlete, I think, than most people had him gauge coming out of high school. He's going to be a major contributor this year for Coach Cal.
He drops a 21 to start. Aaron Bradshaw getting him even more fired up. And we say in the freshman class with DJ Wagner, as high as number four on top recruit rankings, McDonald's All-American Game MVP, three-time Gatorade New Jersey Player of the Year, and family history with John Calipari with that Wagner last name.
Tommy's ahead of the snake is what he is for this ball club. He's smart, he's tough, he's got a downhill game, he shoots the ball well enough that you have to come out and take him on. But his competitive fire and his voice is as good as I've seen from a freshman guard that Cal's had at Kentucky. And he's had some great ones, we've already named them off. He reminds me a little bit of Derrick Rose when I watched his first practice at Memphis. Similar style, similar game, fierce competitor. I think he's got a chance to be special. And
I think the Rose comp is really interesting because Derrick Rose was a guy who kind of eased into his college career. In the month of January, he wasn't a superstar. Then he turned into a number one pick, and he really ramped up in late January, February, and March for Memphis.
Wagner was the best scoring guard in college in high school ball last year, Christy. That's how good he is.
So to summarize you, Jimmy, from what I'm hearing, he's a dog.
He's a dog. He's got some dog in him, absolutely the right kind.
So Shepard with an opening 21, Wagner with a 17. And now Trey Mitchell. And Christy, I know you're really excited, not just to watch Trey Mitchell shoot, but everything about his game and the all-around skill set, how he makes the team better.
Yeah, I'll use the term point forward a lot. I don't think that I've used one as point post. And that's what Trey Mitchell's having to do now with some of the injuries to the bigs of Kentucky. He can spread a defense. He is so versatile. And that's where, if you're a coach, it's a luxury to have someone with his skill set, because the sky's the limit in terms of what these coaches can do and how they can use him to expose other teams.
But, and to her point, it completely changes, like you said, offensively, what you can do. This is a kid that, I mean, he shoots a really good three ball, but he is a playmaker. He may be the best passer that Kentucky has right now. I mean, Wagner can really pass the ball as well, but you can run offense through number four. He can knock down shots. I love his He's an older kid. I believe he's 23 years old.
Yeah, he's got a lot of gear in the closet. Started at UMass and then Texas and then West Virginia last year. Big 12 played 12 points a game, 40% from three. By the way, he started at UMass. He was the A-10 Rookie of the Year, second team, and the first freshman all-conference performance since Marcus Camby in 94, and we know who Marcus Camby played for. So 20 for Mitchell, and that will eliminate DJ Wagner, who had 17 in the first round. So it's Shepherd and Mitchell now, and Antonio Reeves, no stranger to the spotlight. Coach Sixth Man of the Year in the conference last year. You said Derrick Rose a moment ago. Reeves from Simeon Academy in Chicago before going to Illinois State. And a red-hot start for Reed.
It's your pick, right, Kristen?
I know three-point shooting.
You do know three-point
shooting. I also
shooters.
Know stats on a sheet, and I know a veteran point guard. So this young man is doing me right.
Well, he made 80 last year at a 39% clip. I really think he's going to equate to a 44, 45% three-point shooter. I've talked about his driving ability this year. I love his size, Tom. He's all of 6'5", a fifth-year kid. Has logged a lot of minutes, and he'll have a hot, heavy hand early for this young Kentucky team on the offensive end.
At 37 late in the season against Arkansas for his career high. He's got, get the scoreboard up there, he's got 22. So he will move on. And he's gonna try to finish hot, pacing his way to hit the final with 4 seconds to play. What a round by Antonio Reeves at 26. And a late change. Joey Hart was scheduled to go, but we're going to see Justin Edwards at least in front of Hart, if not in place of Hart. And here's another fantastic freshman, part of this number one recruiting class, ranked as high as number three in the country, co-MVP of the Iverson Classic, McDonald's All-America, consecutive state championships playing in Philly.
I think Hart heard that he was my pick, and the pressure was just, yeah. It was just too much to overcome.
He went the way of Christie's Mike.
He did. This guy right here, early talk about him possibly being the number one pick. That's how talented he is. He's a 6'8 playmaking left-handed guy that's a big benefit. He shoots the ball well. He can drive it. Tom, he can get to his spot offensively about any time he wants. Normally we talk about that as a 6'1", 6'2 guard.
Yeah.
Really tight handle, a worker. I thought he did a good job of talking as well. Smooth athlete. The comparison to Trey Lyles, who came out of Kentucky, I like a lot for this guy. Similar size, similar skill.
How you like the shooting for him, Jimmy?
It's really good because he shoots it the same way every time. Now, he's got a lot of shoulder rotation. That left shoulder really gets turned towards the rim, but as long as you're doing it the same way every time, I'm good with it.
And Justin Edwards finished with 15. I'm told we got too many Hearts in the building, so Joey will not take place in the three-point contest. Antonio Reeves with the first round, 26. I got Reed Shepherd with 21. Check my math, but those should be our finalists, right?
And we have Reed Shepherd up first.
And we'll get Reed Shepherd to go first. If you are unfamiliar with the Shepherd family, his dad MVP of the 98 Final Four, Jeff, mom Stacy, superstar in her own right here, 50th anniversary season Kentucky women's basketball.
Tom, he was raised like a pro and trained like a pro. And I was surprised talking to him at Pro Day. I said, did your dad start you on a lower goal with a smaller ball? He said, never one time.
Mm.
And I started with a normal size basketball. And he said, matter of fact, in the second and third grade, we'd go to tournaments and the goal would be at 8 feet. My dad would say, we're not playing in this tournament until you raise the goal to the normal height. So that's not normally what I find from great shooters. They start with a little smaller ball, but boy, Reed Shepherd, the second and third grade, has shot that ball with beautiful form.
And there's something about a Kentucky kid wearing this uniform, right? I mean, he's from the 606 out of North Laurel High School, and that resonates with this fan base, whether, you know, guys in the past like John Pelfrey or Rex Chapman. You get a guy from in-state that can come out and do this, he's going to be a very popular player.
The game means a little bit more when you're from the bluegrass state and you're wearing that jersey. Absolutely.
Well, you heard it when his name was announced.
Yeah, yeah. We did.
Such
you're right.
Such a loud ovation for this young man.
Shepherd with 18. And now Reeves with a chance. If I'm not mistaken, Reeves won this last year, right?
I'll watch the tape and get back to you.
Christy did her homework. She watched the entire thing from last year. Jimmy, she said there's still room for you to improve.
Well, and for Antonio Reeves, he had a bad shooting night against Kansas State in that NCAA tournament, but he had some big games as well. 22 in the opening round win against Providence, 37 at Arkansas. He's wired to score, Christy, a big 6'5 guard. I'll say it again. I think he'll be Kentucky's leading scorer early in the season. I don't know if he'll hold up all year long. But man, is he shooting with confidence. I love the fact that the freshman class got on a group text message and recruited him back to Kentucky. It was a big part of him returning, saying, you're the missing piece.
I can't imagine the confidence
that
this young man is playing with this year, to know that he's the guy with all these McDonald's All-Americans, and he's not disappointing it. But, Jimmy, my question to you, this is a ball club that averaged 6 made threes a year. With what we've seen so far, what do you think they're going to average per game this year?
I think it's going to be closer to 9. I think John Calipari realizes he's got a team that can really shoot. They may play some small ball. When you got shooters like Reeves and Shepard, Mitchell, Wagner, man, that downhill driving game is going to be hard to handle because you can't come off of shooters. I'm really anxious to watch how this Kentucky offense progresses throughout the year.
Antonio Reeves making history, wins the three-point contest. Dropped in 20 in the second round, a better Reed Shepard's 18. And clear some room on the mantle. We got hardware.
He's going to put it in his room. Congratulations for being the second person in BBN history to do what you just did.
Breaking news, Joey Hart said, I don't want to participate in the three-point contest. I want to dunk the ball. So we get Joey Hart in the dunk contest, matching up with Jordan Burks. I'll let you two choose. Who are you taking? Burks v. Hart.
Christy?
Again, I'm going to defer to you on this one, Jimmy. I'm going to take the other one because I'm a winner right now.
You are a winner.
I'm going to ride Reeves' coattails right
now. I'm buying dinner right now for everybody. I'm going to go with Jordan Burks. I think he's an explosive 6'9 guy that's got a lot of pop about it.
Well, Christy, you could do worse than pick a Hart. So we got Joey, the 6'5 freshman, to do what he can do in the dunk contest.
I feel a lot of heart-to-heart going on right
now. A lot of that,
hasn't it? I just age myself with that reference?
No. All right, so Jordan Burks is going to get it started. He's from Decatur, Alabama, and played at Overtime Elite. 27 points a game at Overtime Elite in Atlanta. I'm just curious, as he gets warmed up, will we see Jordan Burks at all in the post with these bigs out at 6'9"?
We could. Cal can invert his offense a little bit and post his guard up because this kid, number one, is good enough to do it. I go back to his advantage that he has as a lefty. Even in the post-up game, you're taught to favor one shoulder over the other, and he can go either way. But Tommy's he's a classic hard-to-guard guy, 6'8". You know, he's very vocal when he's committed to Kentucky about, we're going to win big and win big my freshman year. I like his confidence. I like his swagger. I think he's a terrific teammate. One of the things you look for is from an NBA scout, his body language, how he talks to his coaches, how he talks to his guys. He checks all the boxes in those areas.
Burks first threw down a dunk in eighth grade, but I don't know that he's had attention like this in the dunk contest.
I was about to say, were there this many people watching him in eighth grade?
No, I don't think so.
Has Joey Hart ever been in a dunk contest?
That's a great question.
He's getting coached up by Boogie.
Well, if he's going to use Boogie as a prop, bonus points already. Here we go.
That did not work out real well. And this is my pick, too. He's got 20 seconds to do something.
The pressure they feel when Jimmy Dykes in the house.
Down to 12.
He's building. He is making the atmosphere want.
Oh.
Come on, JB, go get you.
Boogie got cut. Bam! Yeah.
All right, that's a good start.
Keep it basic to begin with, right? Just put it in the hoop. 5 seconds
left. I really like this kid's motor. Now, he came in as not a five-star guy, but boy, he's got a five-star motor and a gear that he's gonna be hard to keep off the floor, especially early with those bigs being out. He's gonna get some available minutes. But he's got some juice and some pop about him now. A really explosive athlete is Jordan Burks.
Now we get a chance to see Joey Hart, freshman from Linton, Indiana, out of Linton Stockton High School. And the Kentucky Bio Blast said off the court he likes to play video games and fish, and the superpower the most he wishes he had the most was the ability to fly. That would come in handy in a dunk contest.
Yes, it would.
Oh.
But Kentucky didn't bring him in as a dunker. They brought him in as a shooter. And on pro night, when Adu Thierro went out with a sprained ankle, Joey Hart got a lot extra minutes. He shot the lights out of Rupp in front of all the NBA teams that were here represented. 20 in blue could work his way to be a factor before this thing's all said and done.
All right, Justin Edwards going to throw another one down. Here's a look at the one Joey got to go. So why not a little Justin Edwards in the dunk contest?
I think Justin Edwards was on the sideline and he said, I can do better.
Yeah, I think he just entered it.
Either that or Adu Thierro just said, hey, I need something for the gram. How about you dunk on me?
He has scary potential, does this kid. Talk about how he can get to his shot. And he, you know the thing that is interesting? He'll be 20 years old on draft night. So he's got a little bit of age experience with him. As Burks now says, I see you and I'll try to top you.
Oh, my goodness, yeah.
Who picked him?
You might win this one, Jimmy.
That's a topper.
He led overtime elite in scoring last year. One of the few three-star guys that Cal has brought in. He's only brought in five or six since he's been the head coach. But, man, I just really like Burks.
Hold on, I need to focus on my man Hart.
Oh, that was going to bring the house down. Yeah! Represent the name, Joey Hart.
The 360. I don't know, some guys are better in game situations than practice. It might be Joey Hart.
Justin Edwards doesn't want to go quietly.
Versatile defender, only 180 pounds in high school. He's already up to 200 at Brady Welsh strength program. A threat to rip those defensive rebounds and bring it quickly in transition to get that run game started.
Who are we going with? Who won this thing? Oh, we're going to do another round. Yeah, you know you have a player-led program when the players say, we got more to come.
Well, I don't think the fans are disappointed with this decision.
No.
Tom, this is just this is just his fourth year of organized ball, Jordan Burks. And that's a real plus, man. His upside, his ceiling is tremendous.
That is scary to opposing coaches. Yeah, yeah.
To be just for your fourth year ball? Absolutely. His growth plate is not fully hit.
Played at Heritage Christian, small school in Alabama before going on to overtime elite. He had 40 points in three consecutive high school games. Oh, we're getting tricky here now with Joey Hart trying to go off the side of the backboard. He's recruited Reed Shepard to help him out. Oh, the left-handed hammer from Hart. Oh, my goodness.
Can I pick him or can I pick him?
I don't know if this is his first dunk contest, but it's not going to be his last. Wow. And what a pass by Shepard. That's not easy to do without practice and put him in the perfect position for Hart to go and bring down the Rupp Arena house. That's awesome.
What do we got? Trophy presentation from superstar Michael Kidd-Gilchrist out here to hand off the, oh, we're not. They're getting ready to hand it to Joey. They're going, oh, we got one more. We'll get Justin Edwards still to go. Reed trying to replicate the pass from the other side.
We're going to find out who Reed likes best.
This is bad, though. He's right-handed trying to pass from that angle. Oh, and he left it just short.
I think you got to go with Joey Hart, right?
Can we just talk about the hardware that these young men are taking home? I mean, that is the nicest trophy I've seen in a
long time. The Big Blue Madness trophy is like the national championship trophy.
So Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, by the way, rocking a Dwan Wagner jersey, sixth pick of the Cavs in 02. And Joey Hart is your slam dunk champion.
Do you have that on your bingo card this morning?
Yeah, my bingo card just has Hart in every square. And everything's coming up Hart tonight. We have the blue-white scrimmage when we return to Rupp Arena as Big Blue Madness rolls on from Lex. What a night here at Big Blue Madness. Player introductions complete. Complete with Boogie Cousins back in the house tonight for La Familia. Antonio Reeves won the three-point contest. He takes home the hardware again. Got to make room on the shelf. And Joey Hart, no relation, wins the dunk contest. And with that, we move closer. And, yeah, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist handing off the hardware. How cool is that? We're going to hear from John Calipari here in a few minutes. But at the same time, we'll get ready and watch a little scrimmage. Pro day. Christy, they went to 4-on-4. Remember, they're missing the bigs. Ogana Onyenso out with a foot injury, doing work on the side of practice there. And Bradshaw, counts that they're 5-6, maybe 7 weeks away. They do have Big Z in the building at 7'2". It wouldn't surprise me if we see more 4-on-4 than 5-on-5. We'll wait and see in here a couple minutes.
Well, I think when you want to play fast, like we know Kentucky wants to play this season, lose the player. It gives you better spacing, and these players are going to be run the floor.
Zanimir Visic did not participate in practice yesterday. He was out here warming up earlier tonight, and he's in uniform in the jersey. I wonder if we'll see him. It remains to be seen. But also as part of this scrimmage, we'll get a chance to hear from John Calipari, his thoughts about this night, this program, this recruiting class, and adding a guy like Big Z late. Joey Hart still shaking from winning the dunk contest. Let's take you over there, courtside, Jimmy Dykes with John Calipari.
Coach, first of all, what a great turnout once again by Big Blue Nation, right?
We got the best fans. They travel, they're engaged. They know everybody we're recruiting. They know where my plane goes, so they know the town I'm in. There's no better place to coach basketball than here. And, you know, to play here, you know, you're a really good player and you're not afraid of this stage. Yep. You bet on yourself and you come here.
Yep.
And that's what's happened, and we got a good crew of kids, really do.
You touched on it in the introduction. How important is it to you, and how does it make you feel when all those great players come back and want to still be around this program?
And the ones that can't go on video, and, you know, Keldon and I went back and forth, Johnson, yesterday. When you coach, there's the good and the bad stuff, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't affect you if it's not family or your players. The other, you know, but let me just say this. When it's your players that are saying it, that has an effect on you.
Yes.
When they're talking about what it's done with their lives and all those things. And I've been blessed. My best players have all been good guys. They're not into their own thing. They're great teammates, so.
Let's talk about your team a little bit. My analysis of your guard play, it's as good as you've had maybe in a long time. It's not just one or two. You got depth at that guard position. Talk about it, please.
Yeah, well, we've got multiple guards. We can play three. We can play three point guards at one time. It's hard to press a team like that. You open the floor, you give space versus running plays. These guys are dead already. He could barely dunk that. I'm going to try not to watch, because if I watch,
you ruin a good night. Coach, let's talk offensively. Where do you envision your team going? How do you want to play this year?
Well, let me talk defense first. Okay. We're going to have to be, like my team's historically, really good defensively with rim protection. If we have rim protection, you can be aggressive, you can take chances, you can do stuff. Offensively, it's going to be more about space than running things. Now, you'll run things when they're all back there. You got to move the ball. But, you know, I think we're a good shooting team. We're a good decision-making team. We went to Canada, and we were 27 assists to 12 turns. And that's after 10 practices and only running a few things.
I was impressed with the story. Antonio Reeves comes back for his fifth year, and those freshmen got in a group text with him and had a big voice in saying, "You're the missing piece." I keep hearing how unselfish we are. I've seen it the last 3 days. Talk about that, please.
Well, there's two things that have to happen for us to be special. I basically every year say you have to be empowered as a team. That means it's their team, not my team. That was the beginning of being empowered. They reached out to say, we need you here. And then it has to be a team that's unselfish and understands if we do well, they all eat. Everybody eats.
I see a little bit of Derrick Rose in Wagner. And Derrick Rose is a phenomenal player, but the upside of Wagner, where is he right now? Where does he need to get better?
I'll tell you what. I've had freshmen. I've never had a freshman that talks on both offense and defense like him. Not one. Because that's what they got to learn. That's the first thing. Yep. If you were in our practice, which you were, you heard his voice offensively, defensively. And now Derek was like his twitch and his, it was not normal, not human, I should say. And so, but DJ, downhill runner, the way he guards, you know, I coached his dad. And I said, Wani, you never guarded that way. And I said, there were times that he was on defense, I turned my back so I wouldn't get mad, because I needed him to go get 25.
Justin Edwards comes in with a lot of hype, a lot of talent, a lot of versatility to his game. What do you need from Justin?
I want him to be a downhill runner. I want him to attack the basket. I want him to do stuff. I want him to do stuff in a downhill. Don't bring the ball and chin it. I don't need jab steps. Remember, we were taught the jab series.
Oh, yeah.
Up and down and then, no more.
No more.
Drive the ball, get to the lane.
I think I heard you right yesterday tell him, I want you to think 80% of the touches, drive it, 20% shoot it.
And he's an unbelievable, get the spots. The best players get the spots. And he's one of those guys that can do that. Get to a spot and score the ball.
You have a kid locally, and Reed Shepherd grew up understanding the importance of Kentucky basketball. What's
Mom
different
Dad,
about those guys?
Let me tell you, Mom and Dad played here. Dad won 2 national championships. Jeff, but Stacy was the player. She was the steals, assists, scoring, played every game, started every game she played here for the women's program, was the first women's star to play. So she's he's got a lot of that. Dad's a great guy. They both are. They know what it is.
I think this could be one of your best shooting teams that you've had at Kentucky, which opens up everything for you offensively. Would you agree with that?
Yes. And what I'm trying to get him to do is not be afraid to shoot balls. You know, right now we're out here, we don't have a do. We have 2 7-footers, 14-footer player not here. No, 21. Z's here, but he did the warm-up line. He just got off the plane 2 days ago. But it's going to be exciting trying to figure some of this stuff out. Look, when those kids come back, I'm hoping in the next 5 weeks they'll be able to, all right, here we go.
Okay.
But you got 3 7-footers, I swear to you, two of them are ball handling. They're more like threes. I'm like saying, why don't we play all three of them and play a 2-3 zone and have two guards in those four?
Keep this tape, everybody. Cal's talking 2-3 zone. Keep this tape.
Zone, the dreaded zone.
So the challenge, Cal, I haven't asked you this in the last 3 days, but it's almost like you're gonna have to coach two different teams this year. Start off small, you add size. Well, How big of a challenge is that?
We don't. Z now gives us size.
Okay.
So we'll have a couple, a 6'9", a 6'9", 6'8", a 6'7".
Okay.
And you still have the big guy, so.
Let's talk big picture for a second. I've told you guys in the past, this is the best collection of head coaches I think the league's ever had. I think it's a league that can have 9 or 10 NCAA tournament bids this year. Your view of the SEC now in basketball is what?
Well, I've said it. Coaches win ball games. Administrations win championships because they want it. And what happens is, not only at Kentucky, now you have a lot of programs committed to the highest level of this sport, whether it be what their campus facilities are, what they pay coaches, their travel budget, their recruiting budget. And a lot of it is the TV, the SEC was able to say, we got a heck of a TV deal. And that money went to a lot of basketball programs. So I'm excited. I mean, we got terrific coaches. You know, Jerry Stackhouse and Buzz were coaches of the year. Jerry Stackhouse, I'm telling you, one of the best offensive coaches,
yes,
and a really smart guy. He hired my son. Really smart guy that he beat us twice last year. Now, the problem is my wife is going to be, she's in the first row.
She'll be wearing black and gold?
She will wear it with Calipari on the back. Believe me, she's going to be rooting for Vanderbilt. Plus, my daughter's up there in the med school.
You got no chance.
Aaron,
I'm done. So I've
just
said
hope she stays in Lexington and lives here so I can come back and see my wife.
Cal, I'm not just saying this. Your heart for others has shown brightly since you become the head coach of Kentucky. And you've always said this position's way more than watching film. I believe your blue-white game is going to benefit the flood victims. Just talk about the importance of the chair you sit in this entire state overall.
You can move people for good or bad, because in what our state, can you imagine, we're not a wealthy state. We have 4 million people in our state. We had a flood that wiped out one part of our state. We have a tornado that wiped out the other. We just had another flood, so we're gonna do our blue-white up in northern Kentucky to raise money for those people. I mean, it's just been like one thing after another, and you know what? We've been able to help.
Well, I'm gonna help you right now and tell you, don't watch this 10 minute of scrimmage.
No,
don't watch the tape.
No, burn the tape. I've done that in real games, burn the tape.
Cal, thanks for your time. Thanks for letting us be here.
Jimmy, great job. It's so much to take from Cal every time, and he's gonna get a mic here in a second, but saying administrations win championships, that's something near and dear to him. And end it with a bang, why don't you?
The players are going to walk around and say hello. Thank you. Now, if you want to be one of the first to watch Big Z play, we're playing in Northern Kentucky. The money's going to some flood victims. What's the date? I think it's next Saturday. You get the 21st. Only got a few, well, they got about 1,000 tickets left. The rest have been sold. But if you want to see them in person, come on up there, and we're doing it for a good cause. Great to see everybody. Thanks for being here. Love your enthusiasm. Thank you.
He never misses an opportunity. I think John Calipari just sold those last 1,000 tickets. Zonimir Ivicic will take the floor, he says, in the blue-white game, which will be played in Northern Kentucky, and those revenues will go to the flood and tornado victims of Eastern Kentucky. Jimmy, what's your biggest takeaway from the chat real quick?
Well, I think he's genuinely excited about his team, because he's got John Calipari-type guards that are difference makers. He hasn't always had that the last 3 or 4 years. When he gets his complete team on the floor, Tom, he's got all the pieces you need. Now, he's chasing Duke right now, Kansas, Purdue, Michigan State, UConn, but he's going to be in the hunt, I think, when it's all said and done. What's going to help him is how strong the SEC is. This young team's going to have to grow up in a hurry. They got a very difficult non-conference schedule, but he's got some dudes now that he hasn't had the last couple of years.
Chrissy, the scrimmage a little erratic, obviously, but your takeaway from watching this squad tonight?
They can fill it up. I mean, we saw fatigue. We saw some showmanship. But I think what I'm excited to see is when their defense kicks in, how's that going to produce the offense for this team?
Yeah. And defense, as he said, Jimmy, is a big part of where he wants to be. That, I mean, that's where he wanted to start the interview.
Yeah, I asked about offense. He started talking defense. That tells you where his focus
that's
is.
That's a championship coach.
That's what it is. But he understands Kentucky has not had a top 30 national defense since 2019. And when they won national titles, they were leading the country in block shots. They've got to get back. He talked about his rim protection. That was Kentucky's biggest problem last year in my eyes. It wasn't Kentucky's offense. It was defensively not being able to get stops. But he's got some guys. Chrissy did a great job of describing DJ Wagner as a dog. He's got some big-time dog in him on the defensive end as well.
Now, the one guy who's healthy who we didn't see was Big Z, Zonimir Ivicic. When I met him yesterday, I said, Big Z, I'm just going to introduce you to the world as the college version of Victor Wembanyama. You're the number one pick, face-up guy. A little unfair, obviously. There's so much we don't know about Big Z. What can be expected for a guy who just got off the plane for 13 hours and has to not only acclimate himself to a brand-new team, but this country and school and everything else.
Yeah, he doesn't know if he's in Kentucky, Kansas, or North Dakota right now, most likely. But what you're going to see from him, a guy can really shoot the ball. I watched him yesterday for about 30 minutes. Tom, he's effortless out on the perimeter. There he is. He's all of 7'2". He's been on the NBA radar since he was 16 years of age in that under-16 Euro championship. So this is a guy that's got the potential to be a difference maker. Can he add some more weight? Absolutely. But he's not real thin. I think he's a type of kid that's stronger than he looks. But he's an offensive weapon and a rim protector that Kentucky has to have if they're going to be a major factor in March.
Jimmy, you and I are old heads when it comes to this experience. I never want to take it for granted. But, Chrissy, it was your first all-in-all your reaction to Big Blue Madness.
Exceeded expectations. Did not disappoint. I mean, I'm still with chills. And every piece of this is a tribute to Big Blue Nation and the fan support, because the fans make our game, and hats off to them for showing up and showing up loud.
Hey, and once we got your mic going, you're a 10 out of 10, I'm telling you.
Thanks for letting me join you guys.
Another fun night for Chrissy Thomas-Cuddy and Jimmy Dykes. I'm Tom Hart, Big Blue Nation, getting a chance to see what their teams will look like as we get to ready to turn the page. The college basketball season, it is right around the corner. A&M versus LSU, SEC women's volleyball is coming up next. For our group here tonight, our fantastic crew in the truck, I'm Tom Hart. Enjoy your weekend, everybody.